Hi guys, Kim here, owner and designer over easydigitals.com, Photoshop backgrounds and templates for photographers. Today, I'm going to show you how to use this free poster title that you can get over easydigitals.com. Just click on the link below this video. So I'm going to put this title on this background that we sell over easydigitals.com. Here's a link to it. The first thing I want to do is I want to see how large my photo is that I'm going to drag it into, because I want to resize my title before I drag it in. It will help keep the styles from getting distorted. They might get too big or too small if we don't do this right. So I'm going to come over to my poster and I'm going to click image, image size, and just look at the size here. So this is 12 by 18. And it's 72 pixels because I made this for web size. It may say 300 for you, which is fine. You just want to make sure that it matches with the width for this one. So that means I want to go back to my style and change it to 12 inches wide, 72 pixels. So now I'm going to cancel this and I'm going to come over to my title and I'm going to check the size on that. So I have image, image size, and I have 10 inches wide. So I want to change that to 12, and I want to change the pixels to 72. And you also get this little box here that kind of gives you a preview of what it's going to look like. You want to have resample automatic on here, and you want to come to this and make sure you have this little check mark on. This is for Photoshop CC, how it will look. If you have an older version of Photoshop, you'll have a little check mark down here somewhere that'll say, it'll say scale styles, and you definitely want to have that check marked, and that's what's going to cause the styles to stay the same. So I'm going to click OK, and it resized it. I'm going to go ahead and increase the size here so it's easier to look at. Now I'm going to come over to my layers, and I'm just going to make sure I select the layers that I want to drag over. So I'm going to press Shift and drag both grab both layers. I'm going to drag this out. And I'm going to come back over to my title and just drag it in. And it's going to say that I have a color match issue, which is fine. So now it's in there. And now if I resize it, it's pretty close to the size I want it, so it's not going to mess the styles up too much. So let's put this back in. Anytime you see text that has this little curve underneath this text, that means it's warped. And the way you warp text is with this tool right here. And you have all these choices. I don't use this a lot, but it is really fun in some certain situations. So this text has this curvature right now. And as you continue to change the words, you may have to tweak this, but we'll get to that in a minute. So let's say I want to change this word to 2014. And I want to change the other word to football. So as you can see, it distorted it and it kind of changed everything. And this is the type of thing I just want you to be aware of. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just make it smaller so it fits. So I'm pressing my shift key and I'm going to bring this in so it fits, making sure I have a little buffer for printing. Press enter. And then you're just going to tweak this until I like, for this situation, I want this line to be vertical. So I'm going to come up, select my type tool, come over here, and I'm just going to change this distortion until I like it, until I think it's straight. And that's pretty good. So as you can see, I also have an issue with the year, so I need to move that up. And you just need to play with these until you get it how you want it. Let me just show you a little bit of, you know, some of the different things that go on here. And then we have all these different things you can play with. I'm going to go ahead and cancel that. Okay, so now I have this pretty much how I want it as far as the words, but let's say I want to use a different color for this football. So as you can see here, it's red. So all I have to do is select this and just choose a different color. So if I want it blue, you can select a color in the image if you have like a uniform color that you want to try. You can even come into this effects and you can change all of these. You can just add, remove. If you double click on it, you can even add more. So there's a lot you can do with it, but this is just a quickie overview of how to customize it. So now you know how easy it is to update this title and change the text, color, and warp. So click the link below to get your free copy of this file. And also, while you're in the free area of my site, I'm going to give you access to all my freebies so that you can play with them and make amazing creations with your photos. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends. Now go out and have a creative day.